This is the Brigadoon in Alloway, Scotland, scene of Robert Burns' rollicking poem, Tam O'Shanter.
Tam O'Shanter is a typical poem by Robert Burns in which he takes an old Scottish folk tale and turns it into poetry. Tam is a foolish Scottishman who is not smart enough to listen to his wife, who goes out drinking with his friends, and soon gets into a lot of trouble. In about line 17, the poet gives us and Tam some good advice. Now, this advice is particularly for the men in the audience. O Tam, hadst thou but been so wise as taken thy own wife Kate's advice, she told thee well thou was a skellum, a blitherin', blusterin', drunken blellum. And even if we don't know what all of those words mean in the Scottish dialect, I think we can tell that that is not a compliment. Tam lingers with his drinking buddies until, as Burns tells us in lines 67 and 68, no man can tether time nor tide. The hour approaches, Tam must ride. And as he starts home, he finds himself in a terrible storm. Only his faithful horse, Meg, can guide him home.
These are the ruins of the old kirk in Alloway. Robert Burns' parents are buried here. Burns describes the scene as Tam approaches the church. The wind blew as if it had blown its last. The rattling showers rose on the blast. The speedy gleams the darkness swallowed. Loud, deep, and long the thunder bellowed. That night a child might understand the devil had business on his hand. Well mounted on his gray mare Meg, a better never lifted leg, Tam raced on through mud and mire, despising wind and rain and fire, whilst tolling fast his good blue bonnet, while crooning o'er some old Scots sonnet, whilst glowering round with prudent care lest ghost catch him unaware. Alloway's church was drawing near where ghost and owls nightly cry. Before him the river Doon pours all his floods, the doubling storm roars through the woods, the lightning flashes from pole to pole, nearer and more near the thunder rolls, while glimmering through the groaning trees Alloway's church seemed in a blaze. Through every gap light beams were glancing, and loud resounded mirth and dancing.
On his way home through the storm, Tam rides upon Kirk Alloway, Kirk simply being the Scottish word for church. He sees the church in a blaze of light and hears loud music and dancing coming from the ruins of the church. Amazed, wondering what's going on, Tam rides up to find out. In line 101, when glimmering through the groaning trees, Kirk Alloway seemed in a blaze. Through ilka bore the beams were glancing, and loud resounded mirth and dancing. Inspiring bold John Barleycorn, what dangers thou canst make us scorn. Well, Tam was so drunk with John Barleycorn, or whiskey, that he let his curiosity overcome his common sense. He rides closer and finds inside the abandoned church a scene of witches and warlocks dancing. And even in the midst of them, the devil himself in the shape of a beast. Well, what would any person with any common sense do if you came upon a scene like that on a dark and stormy night? Turn and run the other way. But not Tam. Inspired by his drunken bravado, he rides closer. He's particularly attracted to one young witch who was just being enlisted in the Corps of Witches that night. Look at line 164. There was one winsome wench in Wally that night enlisted in the Corps. And in line 171, he describes her further. Her cutty sark, o paisley harn, that while a lassie she had worn, in longitude, though sorely scanty, it was her best, And she was vaunting. She was proud of it, of that short little shirt or shimmy, actually a kind of undergarment that the women would wear that wasn't very long. Tam was so caught up in the music and the dancing, and he was so impressed by the sight of that beautiful young lady dancing in her short skirt that he cried out, "Well done, Cutty Sark," in line 189. Immediately the scene vanishes, and in the next instance the witches and warlocks are on Tam's tail, and now it's up to Meg to see if she can rescue him. "Ah, Tam, all Tam, thou'll get thy farin. In hell they'll roast thee like a heron. In vain thy Kate awaits thy coming. Kate soon will be a woeful woman. Now do thy speedy utmost, Meg, and win the keystone of the brig. There at them thy tail may toss, a running stream they dare not cross." What's going on here? Well, if you know your folklore and your witch lore, you know that ghosts and goblins and witches can't cross running water. So Tam will be safe if Meg can just make it across the bridge. Now you know how to escape from witches in case this ever happens to you. Head for the nearest stream. This same superstition about witches and warlocks is found in American folklore as well. Remember the legend of Sleepy Hollow and the Headless Horseman? The same thing happened to Ichabod Crane. He had to get across the running river in order to save himself from the Headless Horseman. Look back at line 209 in the poem, and we have the climactic moment in the story when Meg saves Tam. "But ere the keystone she could make, the faint a tail she had to shake. For Nanny, far before the rest, hard upon noble Maggie pressed, and flew at Tam with furious ettle. But little wist she Maggie's mettle. One spring brought off her master hale, and left behind her own gray tail. The carlin caught her by the rump, and left poor Maggie scarce a stump." So poor Maggie the horse has sacrificed her tail to save worthless Tam. Now we come to the question, was this a dream, a drunken hallucination, or did all of this really happen? You'll have to decide. And now, men in the audience, it's time for you once again to take careful note. In the last stanza, Robert Burns gives you the moral of the story, beginning in line 219. "Now who this tale o' truth shall read, ilk man and mother's son, take heed, whene'er to drink you are inclined, or Cutty Sark's run in your mind. Think you may buy the joys or dear, remember Tam O'Shanter's mare." So if you're ever tempted by drink or by girls in little short skirts, remember what happened to Tam O'Shanter.